It's fun.
Okay. We are Deli Grind Radio, it's a Terrence Henry Show. We live, we in the building, there's a lot going on. Hold on 1 second, why get the echo out? Okay, there we go. Okay, we live, we in the building, this Terrence Henry Show. We got Kiki Vodka here. Everybody's doing their own thing. Everybody's talking in the background, socializing. We got the dude, the sponsor, he's here right now.
Yeah.
The sponsor of the station, Kiki Vodka, is popping, is in here. It's definitely... It's going on. Hashtag Kiki Vodka. It's smooth. It's crisp. It's to the point. It gets you going. Good brother. Oh.
One sip got me good already.
Okay, blue. What is it? I'm sorry.
Free, GMO free.
Okay, bloom G.
Gluten free.
Oh, gluten free? Okay.
GMO free.
Oh, GMO free.
Six times is still.
Oh, six times is still.
Three times.
Oh. he's on the vodka right now as we speak.
Hey, listen, I'm not going to be sure.
No, listen. No. You going to come on this show. You the sponsor. You got to come on the show, good brother. You got to come on the show. Sit down. So how did this all come about? Because I walked in. Okay, I see the banner standing up. I walk in. You told me who it was. How did this all come about? What's going on?
So basically, what we have here, we have Kiki Vodka. That's the product, right?
Yeah, Kiki.
So it's gluten free, GMO free, six times distilled, right? We got a 3-step filtration process that separates us from every other brand, right?
Okay.
3-step filtration process gets rid of impurity, bad smell and taste, and smooths it for your palate. So we soften up the water. So that's basically what we got here. We cut it down with mineral water. You can't serve corn liquor, so we don't give a... Cut it back down with mineral water, distill it six times, which is one more time than the leading selling vodka, which is Ciroc, right? Right now, Ciroc is booming, right?
Right.
They have you on a promotion, so we trying to do the same thing, right?
Right.
Kiki means celebration in Greek, so, you know, celebrate vodka. That's what we want people to do, celebrate our vodka and our product, right?
Yeah. Right.
And here at Deli Grind, I like the brand, I like the situation, and, you know, I want to be affiliated with only good, positive things, so mm-hmm. I said, why not? And this is what we do. We have a nice partnership, and we building a lot of things right now, mm-hmm. and we just taking over. So if you want the product, you go to kikivodka.com. It shows you all the restaurants and bars where you can come purchase the product and drink, right? So we license to self-distribute to anybody over 21, right? But I'm not trying to run around and sell bottles all day, so we looking for distribution and all that type of stuff right now. So I do most of the promotions and build the brand within the establishments that we have it at. So if you follow Team Win215 on Instagram, and if you follow Kiki Vodka hashtag on any social media, you always will see where the promotions and events are happening. I had an event last night in Crab House. It was very well, very nice. You know, so I'm always giving out. Right, I'm always giving out free vodka for people to taste the product. You know what I'm saying? So it's basically how you win. You know what I'm saying? You
right.
give it free now and then you get paid later.
So look, so listen, I'm glad you came along, right? Because we was actually sponsoring somebody else without a check. Who was that brand? Who was you bringing in every Sunday? Go ahead and say it. I mean, you can say it one time.
Oh,
you
just put me on the spot.
Because
right
I got you right now.
I bought a lot of effing vodka. Listen, that's what I like to buy.
Listen, I was afraid when he came in today because I really thought that he was going to bring it in. But listen. We got Kiki Vodka, and this is celebrating. We're going to crack it open, mm-hmm. and we're going to get it going. Alasa, can you do me a favor?
Yes, I can.
Can you give me some cups?
Yes.
Bring them over here. We're going to get going. We're going to come back on the other side. We're going to come back on the other side. All right, we're going to come back on the other side. More Kiki Vodka. Dad's over here getting her Mac on. We're going to get her groove on.
That's what I was just saying.
We're going. She ain't even seen that. Listen. I got to. Look, this is what I do. All right, we're going to come back on the other side. We're going to get into some more. I got the topic coming up soon.
Okay.
So we're going to get into some music. Sir. We'll talk about it, man.
Right.
Let you know where I got it from.
Okay.
All right. We'll be back on the other side. Right. Here we go. Fabulous. Trey Songz. Let's go.
Nice meeting you. Yeah.
Okay, we back. Deli Grind Radio. The Terrence Henry Show. We lobby in the building. Kiki Vodka. Kiki Vodka is here. We actually got a shot now. I'm about to take it. Let me see what it tastes like. Let me see what
shot. Shot. Oh, you want to take a shot?
Mm. All I do is drink Kiki.
Oh, yes.
How you know? My name.
I like it.
Chill, girl. Goddamn.
I like it.
You liked it? Yeah, it's good.
It's smooth.
Ooh, we got this.
Just because I sponsor you,
right?
Don't mean you can't be honest. Okay?
Yeah.
I want the honesty.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I wouldn't say it's smooth.
It's smooth.
That's why I'm telling you, in case you were just going to say, oh, yeah, it's good. F and vodka is.
No, I definitely
No, it's smooth. No, it's smooth. It definitely was smooth.
Yeah, it was.
How you compare it to that thing you like?
It's good. I definitely like it. I definitely like it.
No, I said compared to the thing you like. I know you like it. The thing you like.
Oh, compared to it's up there with it. It's up there with it.
Which one you like better?
Is that what he's asking? That's the basic. I would drink this before I drink that because I can drink this straight. Instead of drinking, I couldn't drink it.
Yeah.
Right. Basically, that's what we want to have, a good product that people could always enjoy.
I'm always avid.
Feeling like, oh, I got to get some water. I got to get a chaser. I got to add ice. I got to get this.
Right. Because I was contemplating pouring this Powerade in there. And I was like, no, I'm going to drink it straight.
That's how I felt.
You know, it went like that. So that's how I was like, okay, yeah, definitely. All right. Yes.
And I said, what you think?
Well, in my opinion, I don't like drinking anything straight. So I had poured like some liquor in here, and I had like a little bit of lemonade. Bugsy poured me a little bit of lemonade, and I drank it, and I was like, "Woo! I need some more juice."
But
that's just me, though.
You're lightweight.
I am. That's what I'm saying. I'm a lightweight.
She's a lightweight.
No, I'm keeping it real. I am, though. I drink everything with a chaser, so don't feel no type of way. But I put the chaser in it, and it is amazing. I took like 2 sips, and I felt it already.
So when you eat something with hot sauce, do you get a chaser to go behind it? Because you say you
eat it. I don't really like hot stuff, though.
You're lightweight. Anyway.
Yeah, but I'm lit right now. I only had like a little teeny bit of this. I'm lit.
Somebody get a drink.
That's how you know she like me. She like, one sip. I'm lit.
No, get a drink.
Yeah, let's go. One sip.
No, Rick.
No, I'm good.
You sure?
I'm good. I'm good.
Wow. You like it?
Yeah,
I do. Your face is irking.
I'm an avid vodka drinker, so I definitely will be drinking this a lot more.
So shout out to Kiki Vodka in the building. So listen, I want to get on today's topic.
Okay.
What I got going on. Okay, so a friend of mine called me over the week, right? She says, Terrence, I got a problem. I said, what's the problem? My daughter went with her father. I said, okay. So I said, what's wrong with that? I mean, well, how many daughters go with their fathers or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. It's the world we live in. What's wrong?
Right,
she says, this is what she says, right? She says to me, she says, Terrence, she was like, when my daughter came from her father, we was in the bathroom, and she did the penis dance. So I was like, okay. I said, what's wrong? I said, I don't know if she's taking her into the guy's bathroom and making her go to the bathroom. I said, he doesn't have a choice where to go, if he has her, right? Mm-hmm. The thing is that her daughter may be exposed to seeing men, you know, go to the bathroom a different way. Maybe seeing a genital, I don't know. The question is, in that situation, as a father you've been, or anybody else that's out there, right, what would you do in that situation?
I'm confused. Explain it a little bit thoroughly.
Okay, thoroughly? Yeah. Okay. What I'm saying is, all right, the child with his father is going into men's bathrooms, and she's going to the bathroom.
In the public restroom.
She may be exposed to certain things, right? Right. In that situation, what do you do? Do you, like, wait till all the guys come out and then you take her? What happens if she really has to go bad? In a situation, you being the father or anybody else that is, what would you think? What you about to say?
Well, I'm going to say like this, in my opinion.
Oh, well, if you got to take her.
She's a little child.
Yeah, she's a little child. No, so she's 3 years. She's four.
She's four.
She's 4 years old.
Okay.
Okay. The daughter's 4 years old. Okay.
So I feel like if the dad is watching it, like you said, he has no choice but to take the kid in the bathroom. However, in that type of situation, they have those single bathrooms and those family bathrooms. So like that should be the first option. Uh-huh. Now I'm not sure how many places don't have those type of restrooms now, being as though it's this gender stuff going on.
Transgender.
Yeah.
Transgender. Okay.
But I just feel as though the first option should be to go into the other restroom, the family restroom. Now, if that's not an option, I really don't think he has a choice but to take the baby in there. Like, I mean, yeah, he could wait till everybody leaves. Mm-hmm. But then while she's in the middle of using the restroom, who's to say that somebody won't walk in there?
Right.
So it's just like he can't sit there with a stranger. Like, oh, can you take my daughter to the restroom? So it's just like.
See, I feel like he could. All right. It's only a one way in, one way out type of situation.
Right.
So you can, at 4 years old, I know my 2 year old, well, she's 3 now. My 3 year old, she can use the restroom on her own. Like, she don't really need no help or anything like that. Me, like, you know, we give her a bath every night. You know, like, she's Fine, but so therefore I would advise him to take her to the woman's bathroom,
right,
and stand outside the bathroom and wait for her.
At four?
In a public restroom?
I don't think so. I wouldn't do that for my child. Yeah. I think you have to have some type of supervision until they get a little bit
in the
more
bathroom
older.
With them.
Like yeah, bathroom. I mean, and my thing is, my daughter's three, you know, and I'm gonna honestly say this. I took her to the movie. She told me, "Daddy, I gotta go to the bathroom." We went in the men's room, went in the stall. I let her handle her business. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to just not be there and supervise my child. She could pee on herself. You know, anything's liable to happen. The toilets could be dirty. She can walk into something. Who knows?
Right.
So you got to be there. So the choice is, to me, personally, she's going to go in the bathroom wherever I go at.
Now, see, I mean, I've had to go through that situation. And, I mean, when Hayden was like 3, 4, Hayden knew how to go to the bathroom, how to wash her hands. Now, it depends on if we talking, you know, veteran stadium bathrooms or we talking TGI Fridays bathrooms. You know, TGI is a little smaller. Instead, we're at the vet, or the link, it's going to be incredibly huge. But, I mean, my child knows, hey, if something wrong, daddy, you know, I'm going to let her go in there. She has to go. She's going to have to learn to get to that situation.
That's what I'm saying. I just feel like you should always prepare a child for when you aren't around.
Right.
Because anything can happen. So I feel like that's what's wrong with a lot of kids these ages, that they be in shelter. And it's like they don't really have no like sense of what to do on their own. Like if something were to happen. And yeah, you saying, oh, she's only three, but I feel like
I'm not taking no 3-year-old to the bathroom.
But listen,
like, it doesn't make no sense.
I'm not doing it. I mean, the course that I took was said that you learn the most from ages 1 to 5.
So you let a 3-year-old walk
in
the public
bathroom.
You're
not listening. Because I said, my 3-year-old is very intelligent.
But
regardless of the situation, I've seen other kids that are the same exact age that aren't as
educated
as my child, because I make sure she's good for situations
I've
like
gone
this.
In some women's bathrooms.
She know how to
pee
by herself.
Said, you know what?
She know how to do stuff.
Right.
Like
women's bathrooms are disgusting.
She know
they
not
are disgusting.
To sit on the toilet. She knows this shit. And it's on... Oop, excuse me.
No, go ahead.
Sorry. She knows this, but it's only because I've taught her this.
Right. But for those that don't, let's say that, I mean, I don't know if your friend's child knew how to handle herself or she didn't. If she didn't, then that's different. If you don't think your child can handle it, then by all means, I've gone into the girl's bathroom and said, look, listen, boom,
so,
my daughter got to go.
You can prepare a child for those type of things, I believe, yes. But in certain situations, who's to say they're going to do what you say when just because you told them?
Right, they
ain't any accountable
situation.
They're not.
They're not.
But that doesn't mean you don't teach them. They're
right.
Not.
You
they
teach
might
them
not,
that, but at 3 years old, you
but what do you think? What do you think is going to go wrong in that bathroom?
Anything could be in the bathroom.
Okay.
Why?
But the child should know.
The area before you left.
So you're saying you'll walk in the bathroom with her, then you walk out and just leave her.
No,
so you're not in there when other women come in.
But I don't think, I mean, honestly, like, my daughter was, she was two, like, between 2.5 and 3 when she started using the restroom by herself. Me, personally, if she was with her dad, I would not want my little 2-year-old, that's just my opinion, I would not want him to be like, oh, she know how to use the bathroom, she 2.5. Go ahead in the bathroom by yourself. I would be like, why would you do that? Because it's just, like, not safe. Like, we started to not sit on the toilet, but she's sitting there by herself in the restroom. She like, my mom not a real one. I really don't feel like squatting. My legs hurt. I'm gonna sit on the toilet. Anything can happen. It's dirty in here. It's like, she's so little.
When your child go home, you get a...
Everybody's parenting is different.
Mine is different.
Like I said, you have children. I have 2 children of my own.
So,
and my kids are, if you ask me and anybody else who knows my kids, they're very...
What's that got to do with it? That has nothing to do with it.
Right. Because of the way that I treat them.
Okay,
I don't treat them like little, like infants.
They are. They're kids. So what did you learn from the bathroom? You learn. Wherever bathroom he takes her in, he has... Let me ask you a question. You got kids? You got kids, Keith?
Oh, no, I don't got any kids. I got 6 guy kids, though.
Oh, God.
And I was just talking to her about the situation where
Come over here and speak up to the mic. Come over here. Kiki Bach is in the building. Make sure you copy the smooth as crazy.
It was a situation where I had my guy kids and we all went to Fridays. And it's, you know, I got two girls and I got one, right? One boy, right? And they all like under five, right? So they like 5'2", right. 3'6", whatever. You know what I'm saying? So my little nephew, he gonna say, Uncle Dame, I gotta go do do. Right? So I'm like, oh snap, I got the two girls. And you, as a boy, you know what I'm saying? So I put the girls in front of the, like, it was Fridays or something like that. Mm-hmm. So I had the girls, like, standing right at the door. Mm-hmm. I ran in real quick, situated him, was like, all right, cleaned up. You know what I'm saying? Look, got the tons of tissue. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Sit on that. Go ahead real quick and do your thing. I run outside, come back, he's swimming in the toilet. You know what I'm saying? He is literally inside the toilet. So it's like, you gotta be there with them because just like she said, you don't never know. But then I got the girls, I don't wanna bring her in the male's bathroom because males be doing, you know, and they young, I don't know, need them to know something accidentally happened and, you know, and they kids, so you don't never know. And right. Especially because I got my hands full with three and I don't got none, so I don't have experience. So I'm just basically like trying my best. And that's all you can do is try your best with them. You know what I'm saying? Every situation is different. Every circumstance is different. You know what I mean? She could be mad at you for saying, why would you let her go by herself? But then at the end of the day, sometimes she can go by herself. You see what I'm saying? But sometimes she can't. Yeah. So it's basically an up in the air thing. Like, y'all definitely on the topic, though, and it's going. Right. You know what I'm saying? Kiki Vodka.
Kiki Vodka in the building. Make sure y'all go get Kiki Vodka. They're the new sponsor here. It's smooth. It's crisp. Get to the point. You don't even need to even take a beverage with it. You can just drink it straight, and you'll be good. Yeah, like, right now, everybody's feeling good right about now. Alisa, she is good right now.
You like, whoa, Kiki Vodka in the building.
So everybody, make sure. Let me see the Kiki Vodka. Let me see the Kiki Vodka real fast. Make sure y'all get the Vodkas in the building, sponsored by the radio station now. And a couple other, where's it going to be? It's going to be out in LA, right?
So basically, I mean, we're working on this. Let me get on this one. Yeah. So basically what we're doing is we're working on distribution right now. We're trying to get it into the liquor stores and all the places that you need to go to purchase the product. But if you want to purchase the product and try the product, you could always go out to a restaurant or bar, which we advertise through our website, which is kikivodka.com. Mm-hmm. And you could always find out where we have the product. We're locally based out of right outside of Philly in Hatfield. We license to self-distribute. We got delivery trucks and all that. So basically, that's just how we moving. You know, you just pay attention to the movement. Hashtag Kiki Vodka and all that. And
hashtag Kiki Vodka.
You'll see on all social medias. You'll see exactly where we at, what we doing, and you know, and that's just basically what it is. Kiki means celebrate, and we want to celebrate our achievements and everything that we doing life together. Was. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Celebration, new success, Kiki Vodka in the building.
Now, when give it up. Do y'all plan to be in the, like, the state store anytime soon? Like the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board?
Basically, that's what I just said. We working on that. We are working on distribution. It will happen.
Oh wow!
You know, definitely, it's just happening. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of things. It's moving faster than us. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So basically, I didn't know I was driving a race car.
Right.
You know, I'm used to driving my little, you know, I ain't gonna say, but the little squad, you know. Mm-hmm. But then they put me in a race car, and now I got to turn into Jeff Gordon. So this is basically what I'm doing. I'm learning the turns. I'm making sure I slow down when I need to. I speed up when I got to.
Right.
And this is what we're doing. We just try to speed DG Radio up. You know what I mean? My man Terrence, and he just, everything's going right. So let's just keep it moving.
Yeah, Kiki Vodka, make sure y'all get there, yo. Yeah, so the conclusion to the topic is, I just feel like, if you're a parent and you feel as though your 3-year-old child can go to the bathroom by themselves by you standing outside there, I guess, you can let them go if you feel that confident. Me, I'm not doing that. It's my first child. I don't know what she's walking into, whatever.
You're a newbie.
No, it doesn't
it's
even
not
matter.
Even that.
It doesn't have nothing to do with it.
But like I said, everybody's a different type of parent.
Everybody's a different
token, some of the things that you might do might be a no for other parents. It's everybody's a different type of parent, so people raise their kids differently.
Right, so, but if I'm somewhere, if I'm at a basketball game, if my daughter's father took her to a, no, listen though.
I'm talking that's different now.
It's not different. It's the same type of situation.
It's not.
That's what I'm saying. That's why when you ask, is it a veteran's stay in bedroom or is it a TGI Friday?
But it's different. If you're there with her, you can take her yourself.
Yeah, no, I'm talking about with her dad. Like, I feel as though, like, that's just, I don't know.
Well, if it's a big bathroom, I'm walking in the Link's bathroom. Okay, how about that? I'm walking in the ladies' room. I'm going in there. I don't care. I'm with my daughter. I got to take her. She got to go. Y'all just got to excuse me. I'm going to close my eyes. Look,
you can't necessarily judge anybody because everybody's different. So everybody raises their kids differently and everybody has different views and everybody has different morals. So therefore, you cannot say, oh, I wouldn't do this as a parent because it's things that you do that somebody else may necessarily not do.
Right.
So basically, I feel this way, though. Like, at the end of the day, like, it's a big bathroom, right? You got a daughter, you're a male, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you got your daughter with you. I feel as though you shouldn't even walk in a woman's bathroom as a male anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You can't.
So at the end of the day, I will bring my daughter with me because she now she has the pass. You don't have a pass because you got a daughter.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You the daughter has the pass because she's with her dad. You see what I'm saying? So you take it, every bathroom that I've ever been to has a stall where you could go in and there's a toilet and you close the door.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So if that's the case and you could bring your daughter in that situation, I think that's the way you should go about it.
Yeah, of course.
You don't go into the women's bathroom and with your daughter. They might just think that's your M.O.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
Not saying that is your M.O., but I'm just saying.
I know, yeah.
Like, you know, we just trying to say... This is a fickle situation right here we're dealing with.
So what we're talking about right now, anybody that just joined in live or whatever like that. So the segment was, okay, if you have a child, and this mostly goes for the fathers, and you have to take her to the bathroom, where do you go? Do you take her in there and let her handle her business, or do you sit outside and let her wait? Now, I know most of y'all are thinking how old she is, what we just say. Okay, the ages are between 3 and 4 maybe. Okay, ooh, so would you let your 3-year-old, 4-year-old go into the child unsupervised by herself? Or are you a confident parent and you say, a confident parent, be like, you know what? I'll stand outside. I know she can handle it. So that's the topic. That's what we're talking about. So if you want to comment, on the situation, you can do here on the live, or you can call in right now, 215-909-9925. Also, we got the Kiki Vodka. We got some shirts. He probably give out one of them, right? 1, 2, we'll figure it out. We'll figure that out. So where's the Kiki Vodka? Show me the Kiki Vodka. Somebody got the Kiki Vodka? All right, let me see right here. All right, so this is Kiki Vodka. It's for celebration, whatever like that. But if you want to call in, make sure you do and call in or comment something live here in the box on the Instagram live. We're going to come back on the other side, get into some music. We're going to end this subject. We're going to end this subject from right there. And, let us know what you think, man. What's up next? SWV. Yeah, let's get into it. Let's go, y'all.
Yeah.
Okay, we back. Dilly Grind Radio, it's the Terrence Henry Show. We live, we in full effect, we in the building.
Yep.
So, the Kiki Vodka must definitely be worth it. Because I don't know what Dez just said. Monday through Friday.
Monday through Saturday. We're taking a break.
Sunday, we're here.
Yeah, no, that makes sense, though.
Okay, it makes sense.
I get it.
But we never take, Tennessee Show never takes breaks.
Never
take breaks.
Well, I'm talking about being
like, I know, live. Yeah, I know. So listen, I'm going to wrap up this conclusion. I just feel like, okay, so when we come back on the other side, we're talking about fathers taking their daughters to the bathroom, and what do you do? So it's one of the things I say. I'll take my 3-year-old child to the restroom. That's what I say. Beg to differ. Dad said no. My children are mature enough to go as long as I stand outside. And I said, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. Because she said children are raised differently.
I thought that was the conclusion. I thought she was right.
No.
I didn't think you was going to go back into what he said.
It wasn't that he said, she said. What you got to understand is here in radio is that when you come back on the other side, people that may have not tuned in, they have to re-elaborate the story. That's what I was trying to get at.
All right, so
that's
why I came the up. Story
but
the,
I just told you. I just told you.
Topic. Just say what the topic is. That's all.
What are you doing?
What
I'm trying to explain is that when you come back to the other side, people are lost in the mix of conversation.
All right.
So what are you doing is that you reiterate the story. Why you didn't have to do that when you do have to do that?
You didn't. All you had to do was say
that. Well, I was trying to do it before you came back on.
And if they don't catch it, no,
before you came back on.
No.
We on set. What's your problem?
No problem.
No, you got a problem.
But literally, you got a problem because you didn't understand.
No, I'm not willing to that.
No, let's
We're gonna talk.
Okay.
So, for people that did just tuned in, right? For people that understand where I come from, right? When I come from a situation, when we come from off a topic, I said two things. We're going to come back on the side. We're going to get into the conclusion of what I've just said so people understand what we're talking about. That's what I said. One, letting everybody know what the situation is. Two, letting know the conclusion so we can close out. She says, well, why are you still talking about something after we just talked about it? Okay, let me explain to you what this is. Right. But when you do that, that's what you do. Now, since it's my show, I'm going to come back on the other side, and we're going to wrap the segment up. If I got kids and they're 3 years old, I'm taking their asses to the bathroom. I beg to differ. I'm not doing that shit. I don't condone it. We coming back on the side. It's the Terrence Henry Show. Okay, we're back. We're back. Dilly Grind Radio. Dilly Grind Radio. It's the Terrence Henry Show. We're live in the building. So we're about to get into it. We got to get right back into it. We got Diva Dez coming up at this hour. So, Dee, what you got for us?
Dez. Today, I'm going to be talking about, first, I'm going to give an example, and then I'm going to go off from there. So, I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with the T.I. and Tiny rumors about them getting a divorce and whatnot. Well, pretty much, Tiny said in a report or interview that was from TMZ that, you know, she didn't feel like it was really an issue that she had male friends. Like, she felt as though T.I., Tip, we know him as a lot of different things.
Oh, yes, I know him as something special.
But she felt that he has a lot of female friends, and he's developed so many female friends, like, throughout his time as being famous and whatever. And she feels as though, like, why is it an issue that I have a male friend? Like, that because he's successful? Like, I don't understand. So what my question is to you guys, to the viewers, and I want y'all to call in, 215-909-9925. My question to the viewers is, if you're in, and I want to say marriage, but Brandon, me and Brandon discussed earlier, he thought it should be like more broad, like as far as like boyfriend, girlfriends, but I feel as though marriage, because I feel like that's when it matters. But when you call in and you decide to tell us your response, you could tell us whether you want it to be marriage or just boyfriend, girlfriend. It's up to you. But, so, the question is, if you are married and you've been with your husband, is it okay for you to have friends of the opposite sex? And if so, how far are you allowed to take this relationship? Like, and how far...
When you say how far, what you mean, like how far you want to take the relationship?
Let me rephrase that.
Okay.
How far are you willing to let your mate, your husband, wife, whatever it is, how far are you willing to let them kind of put guidelines on your relationship?
Like, you mean like, you mean like hang out, you mean like party, drink, whatever?
Yeah, like what are you allowed to do?
Right.
And what do you allow your mate to, you know? Right. You get it, Terrence?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't think you can put a guideline on what they are allowed to do. You should know what's right and what's wrong. I mean, you should, as far as a relationship.
But everybody, you know, everybody right and wrong ain't the same.
That's true. That's true. But I mean, like, you know, if you've been drinking and you go spend the night at the your friend, you know, that's a female, for me it would be a female, mm-hmm. you know, if you I go spend night at her house, that's like a no, you don't do those. You gotta go home. Like, you're supposed to go home. Like that's the rule. Like, you gotta you
but
gotta
is see, that is that just being married, or is that
marriage, boyfriend, relationship, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever. I shouldn't be spending night with no girl at house.
I
shouldn't be. Like,
I agree.
You shouldn't. Like, if I fall asleep, wake up. Oh snap! I got to go. Like, look. I just hang on the stand. I got to go. She's gonna cut somebody. So you got. I don't think you can. But I just think that other person should know what's right and wrong. As far as the topic, I mean, you can have friends of the opposite sex, but you just have to know what's right and what's wrong. If you don't have no common sense, then you ain't gonna be in that relationship, marriage, boyfriend, now, girlfriend, long.
Now,
whatever.
I'm not sure if I said this or not. I honestly, I don't think I did. So, but, all right. So, what do you think in T.I. and Tiny's situation?
Right.
What do you think? Like, do you think that they should be getting a divorce because she wants the beef?
I think Fluey is hitting it.
Shut up.
If I was Tiny, I'd be like, let me throw it in a circle. I know.
Don't change her name like that.
First off, she not because Floyd is hitting Chris Brown baby mama.
I feel like Tiny really loves her family.
What you think, Tay? What you think?
I don't know.
I mean, do you feel like, how do you, like, should they be friends? Should he not be friends? Like,
who cares?
Okay.
Well, I mean, all right, regardless of them, what do you think about the topic overall? Because it wasn't necessary. That was just an example. But the topic, as far as, like, having relations with, like, you know, the opposite sex. Like, how do you think? What do you think?
I don't know.
If you were in a relationship, mm-hmm. would you want your girl spending the night with some dude, crib?
I mean, that's, of course not.
Right, but I mean, but that's her friend.
But when they were dancing, right?
They might have been out dancing. They could have been out. Let's say they
were dancing, right?
Out dancing. Yeah.
They was grinding on each other, right? He was on. Her ass was on his dick.
I don't know.
On top of that, she was drinking Kiki vodka. So, you know, she was a little lit.
Shut up. Or what if they just went to go get something to eat? And then afterwards, they're like, all right, we're going to go play cards. And then maybe they play the cards and she fell asleep.
No, that's not true. He's going to have sex with her. He doesn't respect T.I. If he did respect T.I., he wouldn't be nowhere near his wife. You see, the whole thing is a respect thing. And as a man, you have to respect somebody's wife or any situation. Clearly, he doesn't respect T.I. And that goes a lot for a lot of people that don't respect their husbands or their wives. They're going to do whatever they want to get the attention that they need from somebody else beside the person they should be involved with. It's plain and simple. He was wrong, and he knew he was wrong. And T.I. had every right to feel that way, even if they're having house problems. Or something is going on, and you know that originally that they had beef before. There's no way you should be near there. It was totally disrespecting T.I. She shouldn't have did it. But family first. I heard they were kind of like getting things under control.
They're working it out.
They're working it out because at the end of the day, they love each other.
Mm-hmm.
But she has to understand, just like him, when it's family, wherever it's in your house, stays in the house. Right. It doesn't go outside of the house.
That is the law that I was raised by.
They asked T.I. about the situation like last week on a radio show, and he was like, I ain't going to talk about it. He's like, yeah, but I know. He's like, I'm not gonna talk about it. He's like, yeah. He's like, I'm not gonna talk about it. He's like, and that's exactly what should be done in that situation.
But she shouldn't be doing that though.
Right, she shouldn't be.
Like they wasn't right. Like
no, that situation wasn't right. But if it's a friend that's been around before your husband,
yeah, that's what I'm.
But it's clearly a boundary of respect. Okay, you can have your homie. Not a doubt. I trust you enough to know that you make the right decisions. It's the reason why I was marrying you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the thing is though, you know, if he feels as though or if a sense that he doesn't trust it, if he's getting a little bit too getting into this man's space or whatever like that, he has a right to check her and him in the situation. Because when you marry, you know, different type of rules. Ain't nothing
that
you did when you
and that's what I was saying. Well, that's what I said to Brandon when I said that I was going to make it a marriage type thing, because he was saying any relationship, and I'm like, no, because I think it's a little different when it go to marriage. Like, mm-hmm. I feel like that's when the rules change. Like, that's right. When things are different. That's when you allow. That's when you're entitled to these things. You know what I mean? You're entitled to do this, but as a boyfriend or something like that, I don't feel as though you're
that's
entitled.
It, but like, you got people that've been in a relationship for 10 years.
But that's the Commonwealth marriage.
Yeah, but in the same token. Mm-hmm. They're not married. Like, it goes, obviously, y'all.
So those two are not married?
T.I. and Tiny?
Yeah.
No, that was just an example.
Even if you're not married. So if I go into a party, right, and, you know, I see my girlfriend dancing with another guy, you know what I'm saying? Clearly, she feels as though, I can't even be mad at the guy because I could see myself as that. If she clearly... You know what
it's
I'm saying?
Her. That's who you got your ship with.
Exactly.
That's your choice.
If she choose to do that in the club or whatever like that, then my argument is not with him. My argument is with her more than anything.
Right.
You know what I mean? So clearly he can't be mad at Floyd. Floyd ain't got nothing to do with that. It's her. She created that situation.
Right.
So, so you know.
Hold on one second. Only because we got a little comment. So I just want to read it and then we'll continue. Okay, so Dawn. Hey, Dawn. Mm. This is Dawn from Florida. She says, hey, Desi. Please excuse my language.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Where'd you go, girl? Just stop.
Should I bleep it?
No, you're good. Go ahead.
Okay. That shit ain't happening in my household. respect is number one. And his ass better not put himself in a situation that would in any way disrespect
him. That's common sense right there.
I know that's right, Dawn. You better tell him.
I was going to say, but you know what? Let's take it one step further. Now, let's say if they were mutual friends. You know, you had a mutual friend before y'all got married. Now, maybe that your significant other doesn't like that mutual friend. Do you stop being friends with the mutual friend for your significant other?
Who's going to answer that first, me or Terrence?
Terrence, go ahead.
All right, so I had a situation. I had a friend for over 8 years. Mm-hmm. Okay, 8 years I knew this girl. Mm-hmm. Clearly, the guy she was talking with, he looked a little older. He had gray in his beard, whatever like that. Mm-hmm. He saw me.
Right.
Okay. I'm her friend.
Yes.
Right. Okay. So he looking at me like he probably sized me up.
Yeah. Like
first of all, if I'm somebody's girlfriend and she your friend, she can't be your friend, bro. Hell to the no. You no. too chocolate. No,
listen. No, listen. Not. Continue, so, Terrence.
The point I'm trying to make is that, you know, he may have felt a little intimidated for whatever reason. But if I was continuously wanting to do something, I would have done it. You know, otherwise she wouldn't introduce me to her clearly. But
you know, sometimes people grind me like that.
Right. So in this scenario, what she did was she made something small really big. So what I mean is that something that me and her were supposed to do.
You ain't put salt on the fries.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
So exactly.
Not seriously. I'm just using an example.
Just using an example. So she felt like, you know, okay, well, this guy's actually going to be the one for me. I'm going to go ahead and just go with him and never talk to you again. 8-year relationship.
Shut up!
Well, you got to understand, people that's out there that's listening, people, I want you to be fairly, I'm going to be fairly clear with you and be fair with you about life and situations that be on handle. Okay? In certain situations, people only want what they want. Not what y'all want or where y'all going. It's what they want. So sometimes people think more of themselves than they think of the people around them. Because the people think because as they get older, there's never going to be a chance. And this is their defining moment to make things feel like they work. Mm-hmm. That's why a lot of people put up a lot of unnecessary stuff on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat that has nothing to do with their ordinary life because they're hiding something. Mm-hmm. So I just wanted to say that. So whoever video camera that taped in T.I. And Floyd, it was supposed to happen. It's like it was supposed to happen to me and Dez arguing over the air. I want people to hear that stuff. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything on this show. So anything that's going to be out in the open is going to be out in the open on air. Because right now, somebody's going through argument with their brother, their sister, their aunt, their uncle, or whoever. So I bring everything to the light to let everybody know, like, look, it ain't all peaches and cream. We ain't always friends on here. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of that has to do with me wanting to expose what we really go through. So I can feel the connection through y'all out there in the radio, out there, and whoever's sitting down watching at your computer. We all got people that we all go through with. This is part of life.
It's called life.
So, you know, I came in the moment where I be sponsored by Kiki Vodka. Mm-hmm. Man back there gave me some real influential stuff to like go by.
The guy.
You know.
Right.
But it's life, and it happens. Facts. So, those things and stuff with T.I. and Tiny going through is life. Mm-hmm. It's life. They're going through a real situation with themselves, but they have a child together, so hopefully they'll make that work.
They just had a baby.
You gotta understand something. Floyd Mayweather's lonely.
Exactly.
He has money.
He got money.
He doesn't have love.
Doesn't make you happy.
He got 4 or 5 girlfriends. If the day tomorrow, all that plumbers, he got everything. No, he can't make probably one phone call.
Because money does not buy you happiness.
No, don't get me wrong.
It helps. Money will honestly cause you not to get any love. Like, money if you can't be happy without money, then you don't need money because you feel like you need money to be happy and you're not going to be happy.
So let's take off situation sidebar real quick because I want to get too far to tell from the conversation. But
sorry.
No, you cool. No, you was fine. I was talking about me. So what I wanted to say was is that even the thing with the Kanye West rant, okay, he stated a lot of political things out there.
He did.
About everything. A lot of that is probably say Kanye need help. I don't think he needs help. I just think he probably got frustrated with everybody around him telling him yes. That would blow somebody's mind if you ain't got nobody to check you. You ain't got your friends checking you and nothing like that. You're going to go crazy.
Friends, family.
I can tell you one thing. Cole checked him when he came to that party.
I feel like it don't really, like, Go ahead.
All I'm saying is respect your family, respect the ones around you. You know, facts. And if they're going to resolve it off of the social media BS. Mm-hmm. I think T.I. is a real dude. Mm-hmm. He come from humble beginnings. And I'm rocking out on T.I. on this. And no disrespect to Floyd. He's still the champ.
Yes,
he's still,
Floyd Mayweather.
He's still doing his thing. But at the end of the day, like I said, Floyd really has nothing to do with the Tiny situation. That's all her because she desires the detention to probably make T.I. mad because maybe something they like.
You know attention? Think, that's
you
her
know,
friend.
You know what I think? I think it's the eyes. The new eyes have thrown me off.
So... I want to wrap that up. Thanks, Dez. Thank you very much on the Diva Dez. That was dope.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
We're going to come back on the side. We're going to play some music on the Terrence Henry Show. We're going to get into...
We're going to...
Brandon's going to come back on the side. He's going to let us know about the entertainment news and what's going on in the world. Brandon, what you got going on another side?
Oh, man. They trying to make a Michael Jackson movie on Lifetime, man.
Oh, that's a white man.
We'll talk about it on the other side.
We're going to talk about it on the other side. The Terrence Henry Show. We're going to come back. Kiki Bach is in the building.
I'm lit.
All right, we here. Let's get back on the side, y'all.
That's right.
Here it is, Meek Mill, Dreams of Nightshell intro. Let's go.
That's right.
Yeah, we back. Deli Ground Radio, the Terrence Henry Show. That was some old ditty right there. We about to get into Brandon's entertainment news.
Say something, Jinx.
Intro music. Yeah.
Jinx.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right, so what's going on, bro?
First and foremost, shout out to my cousin, Kalina.
Kalina.
Just played Dirty Money, baby. Anyway, Kodak Black was on a radio show this
past
weekend. He went on this morning show. He's on January 13th. He said they wanted to know why he was going at Lil Wayne so hard. He said he wanted to fight Lil Wayne. If you weren't up on all the news, they said Kodak Black wanted to fight Lil Wayne at the Chris Brown and Soulja Boy fight, and he gave him a disclosed amount of money that he said, "Hey, come on, let's do it." And no one knew why he was so upset at Lil Wayne. So they asked him the question. He said he didn't want to talk about it. But later on in the interview, he did reveal that he was upset at Lil Wayne because Lil Wayne didn't know who he was. Uh-huh. He said Nicki Minaj knows who I am. How Wayne don't know who I am.
What? Now, well, who?
Kodak Black.
Because Lil Yachty hit that.
What does that have to do with Lil Yachty?
Because that's how Nicki Yachty, Minaj man. Know him. Duh.
Shout out Yachty. Anyway, the Florida rapper was very upset. He said, "Nigga, you know who I am." I'm sorry. N-word, you know who I am.
Good.
Nicki Minaj knows who I am. He also talked about how he got his name, talked about his spirituality. He also talked about being uncircumcised. Mm-hmm. The quote him, he said, "I got that banana thing. You got to peel back that thing. Peel it back before you eat it." And a whole lot more. I quote Kodak Black. Shout out to Kodak Black. Now... Moving on to this Michael Jackson movie that they had. It was called Urban Myths. It was with Joseph.
Wait a minute.
Right, Urban Myths, seriously?
Urban Myths,
though.
Huh? Urban Myths.
That's what
right,
it was called.
Right, like, out of all names.
Urban Myths. It was an episode with Joseph Fiennes playing Michael Jackson.
Who?
Joseph Fiennes. He played in a lot of movies.
Is he light skinned or dark skinned?
He's white.
He's a white
man. He's Caucasian.
So we letting a white man play
Michael
Jackson?
Man.
Hey.
Not bad.
So wait, are you trying to say Michael made it a little bit?
If you want to cast a white person for a Michael Jackson movie, I mean, why not? The closest thing to it, probably. So.
Well, the British actor was
British?
Yeah, he's British.
Oh, shoot. A British actor playing Michael Jackson.
Yes. He was going to play. He was set to play Michael Jackson in the half-hour comedy Elizabeth, Michael, and Marlon. They called it Urban Myths. I guess maybe they had two names to it. His daughter was very upset.
Can you let the man finish the story?
I'm listening. She's so annoying. You should see her in the background on the snack. Look. On this face live.
Paris Jackson, his daughter, she called the portrayal shameful after viewing a trailer for the series. She also tweeted out, "She's so incredibly offended by it. And I'm pretty sure the people are as well, and it honestly makes me want to vomit." Well, she did what she needed to do. The show has been canceled. The backlash comes after Joseph Fiennes played Michael Jackson, of course, who is African-American. His skin is darker as a child, but becomes lighter because of his disease that he has, vitiligo.
So that's what it's called, a lago?
Vitiligo.
And then when he finished, tell me what that means, all right?
Now,
vitiligo.
Yeah. That's a disease.
Fertilizer, a chemical or natural substance that enters soil or land to... that's fertilizer.
No, that's fertilizer.
It's a chemical substance?
No, no, no. She looked up fertilizer.
No, I said...
That, she looked up poop. That's what she looked up was poop. Anyway, when Michael Jackson did his interview with Oprah back in 93, they asked him, that, you know, they there was like rumors out there saying that he wanted a white child to play him on a commercial on TV. And Michael said, why would I want a white child to play me? I'm a black American. So why?
A black American?
That's what he said. I'm a black
Who
American.
Who said that?
Michael Jackson. Back in 93.
Okay, black American.
So he said, so basically he's saying, you know, white guys shouldn't be playing me.
Well, exactly.
You know, I'm a black American.
Don't you have to have rights to do that? So somebody had to buy it to do that, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So who's giving up the money? Who's going into the kettle?
I don't know. I mean, Drake might play, be able to play. He's like, I think Drake could play Michael. I think Drake.
You think Drake can act shy and all like that? No?
Yeah. I think Drake is shy already. Anyway, in other Michael Jackson news, on Lifetime, they're in pre-production to shoot a film in Los Angeles, Searching for Neverland, which is going to be told through two of Michael Jackson's bodyguards. You got Bill Whitfield and Javon Beard. They were going to, Whitfield is a former cop and a veteran of the security profession, and Beard is a rookie to the world of personal security. He also co-authored Remember the Time, the book. It's going to be about Michael Jackson's final days, years moving from city to city with three children in order to find refuge from the public eye. So be on the lookout on Lifetime for that.
She's retarded.
Now, what do you think? Do you think Lifetime would do a good job with this? Do you think Lifetime has done a good job?
No, they haven't done a good job with the Aaliyah movie.
With anything.
They haven't did a good job with that.
But you know, a movie I heard was good was the one that they did, the remake for Compton.
Oh, I thought you were about to say
the one I heard not, was good.
Well, her voice was no disrespect to her. The voice was very annoying in the movie.
That's how she really sounded.
Yeah, but that no. We don't need, I'm sorry. No disrespect to you. I forgot the young lady's name, but I don't, you know, my daughter woke up. She thought it was a cartoon. All right. Well, true story. I said, baby, go to bed. I'm about to watch this. So I'm sitting in the room. We in the bed. Next thing you know, she started talking. And then she woke up, daddy, cartoon, no baby, this is a movie. That really happened. That's a true story.
I mean, I can't wait till the 24th. Everybody tune in to BET for the new edition special. The new edition
special. The new edition story.
This, on the 24th, it'll be on BET.
And it look good.
This is going to be good.
Stop.
That's not new edition.
Stop.
That's not even new edition.
That's not even new edition. That's Candy Rain. So you're in.
That's Soul for Real.
Soul for Real.
Oh.
Retired.
Lord, give me the strength.
Go ahead, Brandon.
In other news, Steve Harvey met with the president-elect Donald Trump. And he's getting lynched for it, basically, on social media.
Wow.
Steve Harvey said he's willing to work, that Donald Trump is willing to work with Housing and Urban Development, the secretary, who is now Ben Carson. They want to see if they can bring about some positive change in the inner cities. Trump appeared briefly before the reporters to introduce his guests. He said, here's one of our good friends. Everybody knows Steve Harvey. Is everybody having fun? In Donald Trump voice. Harvey also, you know, hosts his radio show, said that Trump sounded sincere and that he agreed to meet with the president-elect only. Well, the only way they were going to unify the country is to talk to each other. Now, Harvey also practiced his profession about joking and saying that he wanted a Family Feud episode with the Obamas and the Trumps.
No, he didn't.
That's Steve Harvey. You know how he is.
Yeah, I like it.
Think that this was a good move on Steve Harvey's part?
Well, I just think that, I mean, as leaders, it does need some type of communication between who they feel as though was him and the president. Mm-hmm. A lot of people getting backslash for going up there. If it was me and he asked to talk to me, my thing is to observe and find out what's going on, what he wants. Mm-hmm. You know, what they had a conversation about, we don't know, but people were hand-selected to go up there. Mm-hmm. Kanye West, all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. Jim Brown, all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. Jim Brown, who else? Ray Lewis was with Jim Brown when it happened. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they're getting certain people to go there to talk to.
I think Ray Lewis was a good one.
Yeah, Ray Lewis is kind of a good one, but I can't trust him either. No shade to him, but you gotta understand something, man.
He won a Super Bowl.
Some people
he the murder case.
But some people are
Now, no disrespect to him, but some people are yes men, and some people are more, this is what we need. We don't know why those guys is up there, and we don't know what they're talking about.
Now, I'm gonna tell you, Jim Brown is a, I'm gonna tell you what we need.
Right, but Ben, he can't speak for the youth because he's a lot older.
Okay.
And the generation's changed. The game is still the same, but it's a lot more fierce now.
Okay, so you're saying, so who would you, if you could have somebody up invited to meet Donald with the president-elect, who would you have?
Reverend Wright.
Okay.
Yeah, he'll get right to the point.
Okay.
You know, somebody, let's have a debate. You know what I'm saying? We don't need the yes men up there. We don't need the people who feel as though you're okay. We need the people that disagree with you up there. Mm-hmm. Not the people that's going to agree with you. Because as far as I'm concerned, Ben Carson, I give a shits about him. And nor does he give a damn about the community. Because my thing is, and this the thing is that even going back to the votes, it made everything look bad for people who did go vote. The electoral college votes or whatever like that, it meant something for a lot of people. And I know a lot of people upset that he's in. I don't even think people are frustrated that he's in office. They're frustrated the fact that their vote didn't count. And that's
like
the problem.
They're curious, like, right. How did this happen?
So basically, right. We might as well just let all the electoral colleges vote.
And that's been around for a very long time.
Right.
That's been around, I think, I could be wrong, between the time difference, but I know it's between either 1700s, 1800s that this rule was, like, actually put into factor.
Right.
So that means is that most of the urban community that vote doesn't really count like they right. think it do. So that's right. accounting Detroit, Philadelphia,
Chicago,
Chocolate, D.C.
Miami Homes?
Miami, California. Those places, the vote doesn't really count significantly is what they're saying. So it's like, you know, going into this is that people was like, well, why do I keep voting if these votes don't count?
Right.
So now you say, okay, well, who would be best that I can communicate with the urban community? Mm-hmm. Who is this best that we people all that? Well, we can't get the people that's going to tell the truth.
Right.
We're only going to get the people that can say, yes, I can do that. I can do that.
Right.
No and disrespect.
That's why you said we don't need no yes
right.
man. No.
Right. So don't disrespect the Steve. Mm-hmm. Let's get him in there. Okay. He's on multiple networks. Mm-hmm. He reaches out to the urban community. He reaches out to the elderly. Certain
so can
ages.
We tweet that? Can we tweet that out on the Terrence Henry Show page on Twitter?
Go ahead. I don't care. Dad,
I don't got the access to it.
No. All right, we will. All right, him. Uh-huh. Right. And even those people that was up there, I just think that they don't have the right people up there to talk to Trump.
Okay.
And it's not necessarily being aggressive, but if these problems has been going on for as long as they've been going on, what difference are they really going to make by him being in office for 4 years?
Right.
Wow. You know, prove me wrong. Mm-hmm. Prove me wrong. Mm-hmm. Because my thing is, don't get the people with the money up there. Get the people that's actually active. Just get the mayor in there. Let's get the mayor of these cities in there. Let's get the people that we need to get in there, not the entertainers.
Let's get Al Sharpton.
That's what I'm saying. The most of it, you think about it, are entertainers that he talked to.
Right.
He hasn't talked to with nobody right. that hold a significance and no law degree, degrees, and no blueprints, nothing.
Ben Carson, man.
He's bullshit, okay? You can say and you want, but my whole thing is, isn't it the same guy that wanted was supposed to be his running mate?
His adversary and was grinding him up. But
right,
all
exactly.
All
so my thing is this. You let a man talk belittle of you, but yet and still, like, he's supposed to be in control and helping the urban community. One thing you got to understand what Trump said when he was in office, and I quote, they're scared. They need more law in the inner cities. What does that mean? Low income stricken jobs.
Stop and frisk.
And we all said, and this is known fact, what he said was, they said that was against the constitutional rights.
Right.
And he said, no, it's not.
Right.
So he's in president. It's not about money with him. It's about power.
Right.
It's about power with him. And people were saying, you know, let's live our lives, do what we got to do. That's not going to change. But we also got to stay woke out there and what's going on with the laws that happen. You got to know the law.
Right.
If you don't know the law and what's going on, that's how they get you.
No, you can't search my car, officer.
So
anyway,
so that's another reason why a lot of people are fierce with the whole Trump situation.
All right, my man. Now, Dana White finally got to talk about this whole Conor McGregor, Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather went on ESPN and told him he would do the fight for $100 million.
Floyd?
Yeah, he said he'll fight Conor McGregor for $100 million. Now, Dana White said, we'll pay you $25 million. When he went on Colin Cowherd's show on Fox. He said, we'll pay Conor $25 million, then we'll talk about pay-per-view at a certain number. He said, there's a real offer. White's real offer comes just days, like I said, after Mayweather said he'd give Conor $15 million, and he'd take the $100 million, and then they'll discuss pay-per-view. Now, when he told him he'd give him $15 million, he said, now, Floyd Mayweather said, why would I give you know, $25 million to somebody who's never made $8 million, $9 million per fight.
I don't blame Floyd.
I don't blame him either. Because it kind of really is a second. I mean, like, compared to what the numbers Floyd does, everybody buy the Floyd fight, whether you think it's BS or not. We all buy the Floyd fight.
So that's so these are the political correct thing that's going on, what they're doing. It's the political correct. They want to see Conor fight Mayweather. Mayweather is a boxer. Conor is a UFC fighter.
But he's going to get in a boxing ring.
Right. But my whole thing is that, okay, what is this really for? Why do you want to see this happen so bad? Y'all really want to see Floyd just get an L? Is that what it really is?
That's what it is.
I mean, it's the fact that this black man is on top and he's undefeated. Is that what it is?
But it's who can give him an L. I think that's what they... That, and that's the
people he got the, who he got one of the biggest L's right now he's fighting. And that's himself.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But of course, but like I said, you know, they basically, Mayweather said, using fight lingo, he said he believes he'd be the main draw between the two. How can a guy talk about making $20 million or $30 million if he's never made $8 to $9 million in his life? Right. Now, Dana said, what makes you think you're the bigger draw? Now, that's what Dana White said. Now, I think Dana White might be crazy. I think he might be a little crazy. Just a little schizo, because... We all know Floyd is the draw, but you know we'll see what happens. And last but not least, Queen Latifah just revealed some big news on Friday that's gonna put a smile on some of you women's faces.
She came out.
No, I heard she getting dug down by a dude.
Oh, really?
Shout out
Queen Latifah.
But while she made an appearance on Bravo's Watch What Happens Live on Thursday evening. The acclaimed actress said that the rebirth of the hit 90s sitcom Living Single might find a place on TV.
Shut up.
Yet again.
Shut up.
They said they're actually working on it. She revealed after answering a viewer's question about a potential reboot. She said it's not there yet, but hopefully they can get it to happen.
No.
What? No. You didn't like Living Single?
First of all, let's get it straight.
I go back to 90s TV all day.
Yo, me too.
Let's get it straight. You can't revive something in the past like that. There was a good body of work with the day's age and how things are now. People probably won't even appreciate
it. You're wrong. Full House is doing numbers. Muller House.
The new one.
Okay.
The old one. You know, like the never grown. But the only reason why you feel like that is because that's not what's offered to us.
Nearly. The Gilmore. Like you said. I think there's a home for it at?
Where?
Netflix.
Yeah, Netflix maybe. How are you going to do the show?
That's what Fuller House is.
Alright, so you put on Netflix, I can see it going.
That's what the Gilmore Girls is. They're doing numbers. And Netflix is booming. They just had a meeting where they had the most revenue they had in the last 5-6 years.
Yo, Living Single will kill it. Are you tripping?
And Orton said he's willing to do it.
Shut up.
John Henson Jr.
Yeah.
Is his name? John Henson Jr., who used to play Orton, the bald head bull.
Oh, him?
Yeah, he said he got a check. He ain't got no job.
Everybody going to do that shit.
Overton. Yeah,
they're going to do Overton.
But, I mean, Regina, I'm sure you can get all of them to come back and do it.
If there was a
90s sitcom you could bring back. Hold on. If there was a 90s sitcom you could bring back, what would you bring back?
Oh, 96, you said? 90s. 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 I ain't going to lie, man. I did used to like Boy Meets World, though.
That's my brother right there, dog. That's my
stuff. They brought back Boy Meets World as a sequel.
No,
as a
girl. It's girl not meets the same.
World, and they put it on Disney. It actually just got canceled because it was on Disney. If it was on ABC, it was a good show.
I watched every episode.
Show. It's a good show. My
daughter watches it. It's not the same. Don't you judge me. All right. What would you bring back, Dad?
I love Family Matters.
Family Matters was my favorite.
Urkel's
a little too old to be Urkel.
No.
Yeah, he's older. Jaleel a little older.
Then he became Stefan.
Jaleel's still spending Family Matters money.
He became Stefan.
Yeah, he is. He just bought an Aston Martin and he's still spending Family Matters money. Dang. Shane, what would you bring back, Shane?
I can't really pick and choose, but I got like a top three that I would bring back.
Okay. Oh, I got it.
I would do either Martin, the Wayans Brothers show, or Seinfeld.
Okay. All right. See, me, I bring back Martin.
But listen, what about the show where, what the freak was it? And it was like, the guy who lived in the garage Step House.
Step by Step.
Was it Step by Step? Yeah, step by step.
Yes.
Day by day.
Oh, you ain't got to sing the song. Yes, that was it. That was the show.
People you know.
Yes, that was the show.
I like.
She crazy.
Yes, I like that's
hey,
and Mr.
Hey,
Cooper.
Hey, hang on, Mr. Cooper. If you want a comedy show that you would bring back from the 90s.
Call us 215-909-9925.
You're going to get out of here.
Y'all better call next week. The phone didn't ring this Sunday.
Listen, that's the entertainment news. I'm Brandon Harper, Bruce Banner. I'm out of here.
Yeah. So we're going to wrap up the show. Good show today. Mm-hmm. Good show. Shout out to Kiki Vodka.
Kiki Vodka!
New sponsors.
Yo.
Dudley Grind Radio.
The right way.
That's right.
The right way.
That's right.
You got the camera on. The right way.
So, that's right.
Shout out to Kiki Vodka for coming in.
It's
real smooth. It's crisp. You get to the point.
That's right.
So make sure y'all hear more details about it. Make sure y'all hashtag Kiki Vodka. Make sure y'all hashtag
it.
And then once you hashtag it, it'll be dope. So make sure y'all shout it out. Kiki Vodka's in the building. We here. New sponsors, Jelly Grout Radio, the Tanner Simmons Show. Oh, it's going down, man. It's one of the best, Kiki Vodka. Make sure y'all check
it's out. It's smooth.
It's smooth.
That's right.
It goes for, like my man said, celebration. So it's all about celebration. It's all about what you're doing.
Every time you link up.
2017. Make sure Kiki Vodka's in the building. Terrence Henry Show. We out of here. We see y'all next Sunday.
See you. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Chang gang.
Peace. We out. We out. We out. We out.